So I do jet noise research for both the US Navy and NASA. For the Navy, I'm interested in reducing the jet noise from their tactical fighters. Think of the F-18 that sits on an aircraft carrier, and there are people sitting very close to the exhaust of the fighter. And so what I'm trying to do is find ways of tickling the jet to make it slightly quieter by pushing energy from loud motions of the jet exhaust into quieter motions of the jet exhaust. For NASA, I'm interested in reducing their jet noise problem, but theirs is different. Their noise is dominated not by the exhaust, but by the fan that you see when you look at a jet engine from the front. There, the fan has a large number of blades, you know, 50 blades or more, and each of those blades is responsible for a little bit of noise. What NASA is interested in doing is understanding how each of those individual blades and collectively create noise that is becoming to be the loudest part of commercial aircraft noise. One of their visions for combining jet engines and propeller-driven aircraft is to take jet engines and use them instead of thrust producers, but as energy producers that power generators, and that energy from the generator is distributed to small electric motors distributed across the wing of an aircraft. We use XSEDE resources because there's no simple way of writing down on pen and paper how much a jet engine produces noise. So instead what we do is we use computer programs that solve for the motion of all of the gas behind a jet engine. XSEDE is necessary for two reasons. One, they provide the computational support for those calculations, but they also provide the people through ECSS. XSEDE's extended collaborative support services have helped us over the years by making our programs much more efficient, so we can use the same amount of resource, but produce much more useful information and thereby making engines quieter more quickly.